So once we have our drawing ready and all of our layers that we want are turned on, we can select everything and go to File, Export, Selected. And we're going to just navigate to whatever folder you're saving this in. Mine is going into Tutorials, and I'm creating a new folder for this tutorial. I always give my site plans a scale so that I know what they're meant to be. And I'm going to change it to Illustrator and then export with 1 meter equals 5 millimeter. And now I'm just going to drag this into my Illustrator. Your drawing is going to be quite large depending on how big of an area you've selected. And I just wanted to show you this because I knew that we would have to run into this troubleshooting at some point. The canvas in Illustrator is set to a fixed width, and our drawing is way too big for this. Even if we select everything and try to drag it over so that it's centered in the middle of the canvas and in the middle of the artboard, we can't do that because Illustrator will give us a message that says moving would cause this to go outside of the drawing area. So if you ever run into this issue, it means that you're going to have to reduce the amount of information that you're importing into Illustrator. And we can do that in Rhino by being more specific with what we want to bring in. So I'm going to draw a rectangle. I'm just going to use REC for rectangle. And I'm going to draw what amounts to basically a square around the area I want to focus in on. So I'm just holding down shift to constrain this to a square. And depending on where you're studying and what information you need, you can move this around. But what I'm going to do is copy all of this line work by holding down Alt and pulling up on the Y-axis in my gumball. So I've created a complete copy. And then I'm going to use my rectangle, my site outline here, as a trimming object. And then I'm just going to select all of the line work that is around this trim object and use it to get rid of everything. So I'm going to have to zoom in and get close and make sure that I've gotten all the buildings and all of the little bits and pieces. But after I've done that, I can delete everything else that's outside of my square. Now, I don't know if I'm going to need this full rectangular site that's below in the future, but I'm just going to keep it just in case. If you're pretty sure that you're not going to use it, you can get rid of it. But I'm going to select it and then use G for group, and I'm just going to hide it. And then I'm going to select this line work up here and move it down to the origin. So I'm moving it down to 0, 0, and I might just have to ungroup it and get rid of a few extra little pieces here. But then I can select it all again, and I'm going to group it with G for group, and then I'm going to bring that into Illustrator. So File, Export, Selected. I'm going to save over top of my previous site plan and just close out the one that I had open before. And I'm going to use the same setting. So 1 meter equals 5 millimeters is 1 to 200. And now I'm going to open that up and begin assigning line weights.